Hello students, we meet again. So I'm Wiwi Andriani from Binus University. And our program is Be Proficient in English with Binus. Let's look at our learning objectives. We have two learning objectives, but I think number one is already discussed in the previous lesson. So in this session, we are focusing on number two. At the end of the session, you will be able to use passive voice in your sentences. So you yourself are supposed to write your own sentences in passive construction. Let's review first. On explanation text, yeah? So our last session, we discussed how to write an explanation text and how passive voice is used in the explanation text. Yeah? So why do we use passive voice a lot in an explanation text? Because usually a text which explains how a process happens is written in passive construction. So this is the feature actually of an explanation text. The first one, usually you use simple present tense, and the second one, you use passive voice or passive construction. And I just want to review a while, yeah, the last text here about stamped batik and painted batik. Yeah, do you remember which one is passive construction in this text? Can you find some passive passive construction? So how many of them? The first one, yes, you're right, yeah, is made. So this one is simple present, yeah, is made. Okay, another one is called, yeah, so to be plus past participle. The third one is done, again to be plus past participle. Then if you use models can, then you just put be, yeah, can be, and then past participle. Okay, so this is the form, yeah, again, be plus past participle. So if you want to write passive voice, then you have to know the past participle of the verbs you used. It should be past participle. There is no other form. And again, is to review when we use passive construction. I think you still remember. The first one is if you focus on the object, not the action. And then the second one is when the performer of the action is not known or irrelevant. Yeah? Okay. And this one is how we compare passive and active voice. It's usually done. Passive gets up, active. Can be found, passive, can sing, active. Then number three, Maybe you can tell me which one is the passive one? Yes, you're right. Has been sent is passive and has sent is active. Okay, now it's your turn. Yeah. Please make passive sentences from these words. So you have the red bicycle, and then the verb is give, then me, and then a birthday gift. So how do you write the sentence using passive construction? Okay, great. The red bicycle was given to me as my birthday gift. So you have to be was, and then you have past participle given. Okay, well done. Now number two. It's the same. Please use passive construction. Bali, and then visit. Lots of tourists every year. Okay. Bali is visited by lots of tourists every year. So you have to be is and then past participle visited. Well done. Okay. Now you have to tell me, yeah, you have to inform me, is it active or passive? Look at number three. The principal, and then award, and then outstanding leadership. So how do you write the sentence? You cannot change the order. Yeah, so your sentence should begin with the principal. Okay, what will be your sentence? Yes, you're right. The principal is awarded for his outstanding leadership. Is it active or passive? You have is as to be and awarded as past participle. So this one is passive. Yeah. Okay, the last sentence. My teacher and then usually and then join a piano competition. Okay. So is it active or passive? Yes. My teacher usually joins a piano competition. So it's an active sentence. Yeah, usually and then joins. Okay. Okay. So by doing this exercise, I do hope that you can try to use active or passive sentences in your sentences. Okay? So thank you for watching and practice a lot.